Okay, we're going to look at how to estimate these limits graphically now. We looked at it numerically, but as the input gets close to 2, what do we look at there? Well, I took the liberty of preparing graphs. I just used Desmos. As the input gets close to 2, you're saying, hey, the input's getting close to 2, near not at from the left and the right. Oh, the outputs are getting close to something. The outputs are getting close to something. What is that something? Well, that's 1. And you could zoom in here, but that's 3/4. Oh, that limit is 3/4. How about that? That's actually what we got numerically. Okay, what about this one? What happens as the input gets close to 2 there? Well, you could change that in the graph and notice what's happening as you come from the left. Well, you better not come too far from the left. You need to be near. If you're down here, you're going to be on a totally different piece. But if you're near, you can sort of see that's coming up from the right, near, not necessarily at. They're going to be coming to a height of 0. One's from above, one's from below, and you get 0, just like we had before. Okay, what about this one? This was the interesting one. Limit as x goes to 2 here. Notice 2 is a vertical asymptote. That's really what we had going on. If you're asking from the left or the right, the answer is, I don't know. You could be getting really big from the right. You could be getting really small from the left. But if you're in this situation where you say only from the left, then suddenly it's predictable. And you say, well, if I'm just coming from the left, I'm going towards negative infinity. So this is negative infinity. This is does not exist. And life is grand.